that young. You know what I can do, but the good thing is that I've had at 42, probably more years of teaching. I've taught I'm almost 10 years in a community college, 17 years in the university system, 13 years in the state university, a couple of years working in the public schools, a year in the private school, a lot of church, I've had a lot of experience in terms of teaching different people, different things. And I'm very fortunate because many of the students that I've taught in the past always come back and support me. I have so many alumni students who come along to make this special presentation happen for me. And I would like to ask all the alumni to raise their hand for me. I would like to thank those individuals for surely, whenever I have asked people to come, they always come. They always support and love me. And I'm so thankful for that. I am also real thankful to both choirs. Both choirs are quite different. One is from the university and one is from a community approach. And but I try to make sure that I represent material that is good for each of them. And we both sponsor this. We don't get together to sing a lot together. But they know of each other and they hear each other all the time. But I am so thankful for all the students behind me who have just been work together, because many of them, especially from the choir, Los Padanos, they're working with adults such as I am, so they have to take a day off of work to adjust to come up here. I want you to thank them for coming. They are just a special group. I would also like to thank our sound engineer. I was always yelling at him in the back, but he really is a wonderful person. He brought all the support for us. Give a hand, that's Mr. Ryan. And Mr. Ryan's awesome, people alone. And then also, I want to introduce all of you to my wonderful wife, we've been married for 20 years. To my wife and my daughter, my wife, Cecilia, and my daughter. My wife is also a choir teacher. She has a wonderful choir program at her high school, at Deer Valley High School. And my daughter, who looks just like her mother, stand up. I have two other daughters. Now, if I didn't introduce it, they would say, you know, they didn't tell me to stand up. But I am really thankful for all the support. But I am most thankful for this organization, once again, Dr. Anna Hamry, for having invited us. We tried to actually do a journey of a gospel. I hope that you would have developed an aesthetic appreciation. It's not for everybody in terms of every single environment. That's why I try to make sure that I go through all the various styles, and hopefully whatever would be your kudos in your life, you could grab. I really would encourage many of you to involve gospel music and curriculum throughout California. One of the reasons is because, as you can tell, that it's one of the few forms that have a way of being very engaging and inviting people of all cultures and diversity. And the goal of education is not to create an idea where the music educator's job really is not to create a diet of music. The music educator's job is to create good skill and give good skill and good learning and allow the student to take that. And hopefully, you would have introduced some learning and some discipline of which they can move on and impact their own lives. I heard the president of this organization tell me that 25 years ago, she was a past president of Dr. Colonel Linderman, and I never forgot that. She said in the curriculum class that educators, the goal is not for them to make duplicates of themselves. The goal of educators is to simply allow the students to express themselves in the manner by which it is good for them, but to give them working skills, to not allow them to do various types of music with those skills, to teach them how to read, to teach them about reading and singing and all those wonderful things, and to allow them, hopefully, if you encourage them enough, they will develop a greater appreciation and aesthetic appreciation for various types of music. But one of the things about music is as diverse as people. We are all in this room, we're all different. There's some people who like to go to Macy's shop, some people who like to go to Capitol's shop. Some folks, like I am, go to Walmart to shop. But you know what? Everybody still wears clothes. And so having said that, I want to thank you once again. There's always a place in life where everyone is always looking for happiness. And happiness comes in many forms for different people. And happiness, many times, comes in the form of children. And in the Christian vernacular, Jesus uses it, that word that people use. But for those who perhaps don't profess that in terms of an actual faith, perhaps they may have another source of power. We simply ask that you deepen your soul and find whatever that source is. We are going to end our program with you with a song that's called Central.
Thank you.